acid, and it is present in every living organism. So if you have DNA, I have DNA, this banana has got DNA that we can start from it. It basically holds life as we know it.
So today we're going to extract DNA from this really ripe banana.
Yes. Okay. And you can do it all with household stuff.
So everything here we can find at home?
We can.
And can you extract DNA from other things that's not a banana?
We can. So you can extract it from strawberries, from blueberries, from blackberries, from potatoes, I guess.
Ooh.
Any fruit and vegetable you have on hand, you can give us a try.
Okay, so let's try the banana today.
All right. So we're going to go through what we have, what you need to extract DNA. You need one Ziploc baggie. You need your extraction solution, which is a half a cup of water, 2 teaspoons of dish detergent, and 1 teaspoon of salt. Give that a good mix. You need a transparent glass or small mason jar.
Okay.
You need some coffee filters, a funnel, and some rubbing alcohol that we'll put in the freezer to get it nice and cold for the extraction.
So does it have to be glass?
No, it does not. It can be plastic, as long as you can see through it, so you can see your separated layers at the end of the extraction.
But the alcohol has to be cold.
It has to be cold.
From the freezer cold, fridge cold?
Preferably from the freezer cold.
So okay.
I already have a bottle of this in the freezer, but before you start the extraction, this is the first thing you should put in the freezer. Get it nice and cold for your extraction.
Okay, so walk us through the first step.
So the first step, we're going to mechanically crush the banana to help create more surface area for your extraction solution to bring out the DNA. So, shall we start?
Yes.
Okay.
So, okay, so we do a
half. So this is a very ripe banana. It's going to go to good use for science.
For science.
Dump it in your bag.
Okay.
We're going to mash it up real good.
So you're mashing it, you're physically breaking up the banana. You're physically separating the banana cells, like Christine said. You want to increase the surface area so we can get the DNA out of the cells.
Okay. This will make your extraction more efficient. So you just want to get all the clumps, as many clumps as you can, get it nice and mushed up. And what's our next step, Michelle? We're going to add.
So the next step, Christine, we're going to add the solution that you made, which contains the water, the dish soap, and the salt. And the soap is going to break apart the cell membranes so that your DNA can be released. And then your salt is going to, what is your salt going to do?
Your salt helps the DNA clump together so we can visualize it better.
Okay. So how much of this pour in here?
A couple tablespoons.
Okay. So this is a 1 tablespoon spoon that Christine has.
Yep. And Michelle's going to move in the bag for me so I can go. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Does it have to be precise?
It does have to be precise. Just okay. Want to make it liquidy enough that it can go through the coffee filter. So let's start with 4.
It smells very nice, Christine.
It does.
Smells like soap.
Alright, so.
Okay, so now what?
Now you've got to mash it up.
Mash it up some more.
But you want to be careful and try not to create too many bubbles. Just so it's not too difficult to put through your coffee filter in the pan. So I'm gently just mashing the banana up, getting the DNA out of those cells.
Okay.
And do this for about until you get most of the clumps nice and mashed now. I think that's pretty good. So we try extracting from this.
Okay.
Alright. So the next step, we're gonna wanna filter out all the gunk and just end up with a solution that has your DNA in it.
So this is looking good?
That looks good.
I think I grabbed your paper towel or something.
Okay. It's a little bit messy.
It's a little messy, guys.
But it's fine.
Yeah.
It's fine.
Because none of this is hazardous, right?
No, it's drink this. It will not taste good. Next step, we're going to grab our empty glass or plastic cup, okay? Put your filter in it, okay? Your funnel, and your coffee filter as well, okay?
So I'll let you pour it on the steam.
You want to pour?
You want to hold this?
I'll hold this, all right. So then we pour this in,
okay? We'll show you guys this. Oh, nice.
Going through very slowly though.
So can you all see? It's very slowly, but it is filtering through. So what is this liquid now? What would it?
So that contains your DNA. It doesn't have any of the protein or cellular gunk that's all trapped in the filter right now. So you should be able to extract or precipitate the DNA out of the solution using the ice cold ethanol that we have.
So a little bit, yeah, we'll wait a little bit. So DNA is soluble in water,
yes,
but not soluble in alcohol,
yes.
And that's what causes it to precipitate. So look,
there you go.
Glass caps there, perfect.
I'll go grab the ethanol. Okay, first.
What do you think? Can we squeeze some of that out?
Yeah, you can try and gently squeeze it. Try not to break the coffee filter.
You have a garbage can handy.
Make me up easier.
Yeah.
There you go. I'm squeezing it just very gently from the top to kind of help that liquid get through.
I think that's it. Alright. This is waste. All those are garbage.
Alright. Let's see. I'll let this sit.
Oh, okay.
Get the pepper.
So that's nice. You can see the separation. Yeah.
Those are all your strands of DNA clumped together.
So here's a close-up of our extracted banana DNA. Let it sit for a little bit.
Yeah.
So then if I take a spoon, look at that cloudy stuff. It's not as clumpy as we thought.
No. So but you can still see it.
You can see it.
And you can try and pull it out.
Can't pull it out as well as we hoped, but you can see. Oh, can you see that wasn't very good?
Oh yeah.
You see the cloudy.
Yeah.
So those are.
That's your banana DNA.
Banana DNA.
Have fun extracting your own fruit DNA at home.
Have fun, guys.